we should have certain circumstances which justify jihad and certain circumstances which can secure certain positive results for jihad. Otherwise, we have to be patient and to face the situation by firmness, by insisting on our faith, but not with doing something that will make the situation worse and bring catastrophes to us and to the Muslims and to Islam. We do not want the world to say Islam is connected with violence, because jihad, Muslims think that if they do this violence in the name of jihad and they are killed, they will go to paradise as martyrs. Martyrdom does not mean, as I said, committing suicide. Martyrdom should have a price, should be in something positive, not just killing yourself for the sake of killing yourself. All this should be clear in our minds, not to confuse ourselves or confuse others. Then what can we do? We should reform. We are here to live, not to die. We are on this earth to make it a better place. And even if the difficulties are so big, we have to be patient and to be persistent in making any reform, the slightest reform, within the community, within your neighborhood, within your family. If you bring your children to have a better future than you, then you are doing jihad. If you are cooperating with other Muslims to improve their situation, you are doing jihad. If you want to help the poor and the needy, this is jihad. If you want to educate the ignorant, to let them know what they should do, this is jihad. We are here to reform the bad situation, not to die. We are here to make our life better, not to leave the life and go to death thinking that we are going to paradise. We have to do our best and to be patient and persistent. And to do what can we do in ourselves, in our families, in our neighborhood, in our community. We cannot reform the whole world. And also we cannot declare war against the whole world. And also we cannot commit suicide. Committing suicide is escape. It's a sort of escape from facing the responsibilities. The responsibilities towards your faith. The responsibilities towards yourself. The responsibilities towards your family. The responsibilities towards your community. The responsibilities to do what you can do with regard to reform and to reform the whole humanity as you can and within your ability. This situation has to be clarified. Jihad is doing effort to the maximum for reform, reforming this life, not just to die. And the martyrdom is not, and the shahada and the istishhad is not committing suicide. Committing suicide is haram, is prohibited by Allah. You cannot kill yourself. So killing yourself in the name that you are practicing jihad is not an excuse. Jihad has its conditions and its requirements. It has its justification. And you should do it and while you are having trust that some improvement will happen as a result of your sacrifice. But you sacrifice without any price, you are adding to the loss. In addition to the loss of others, you are losing yourself. And this will not reform the world. This sort of thinking that jihad will bring us a miracle, will make Allah interfere for our benefit. This is wrong. Allah has left the human beings to the laws that He has put. He has said in the Quran, ذَلِكَ وَلَوْ يَشَاءُ اللَّهُ لَانْتَصَرَ مِنْهُمْ وَلَكِنْ لِيَبْلُوَ بَعْضَكُمْ بِبَعْضٍ. Allah can defeat the enemy of the faith, of Islam, of Muslims, but He leaves the Muslims to His laws. He leaves the Muslims for their responsibilities to work hard and to work persistently for their goals. And in this way, they will win one day or another. If not today, maybe tomorrow or after tomorrow. This sort of struggle needs patience and persistence. And it cannot bring its results in one day or another. The one who thinks that when he dies, he gets rid of this life and relieves himself, this is wrong. Because the community is still suffering. And you should not be selfish, thinking only about yourself. And suppose that you die. What is the result? Are you sure that you will go to paradise? Are you obeying Allah in trying to do the reform as you can and in fighting evil as you can, not just escaping from life and from confrontation? We have to think again and to think seriously about ourselves, about our community, about our faith, about the future of Islam. Then our vision will change. On the contrary, we want to live more, to work hard. Of course, when death comes, we cannot resist. But we have to work hard as if we are living forever. And when we die, our children will inherit the responsibility. And we raise our children with this faith that they have a responsibility not only towards yourself, themselves, but towards the community and their faith. It is a continuous struggle which needs, as I repeated, patience and persistence.